you yourself feel about the white man?
I believe that the white man has done a great injustice to the black man in this country by having kidnapped our people and brought us here and down to the level that we're on today. And today, instead of approaching the factors that their original mistake has created, instead of approaching these factors objectively and realistically, the greatest sin that they're doing now is trying to pretend that they never committed a crime, that they never did any wrong. And when the Honorable Elijah Muhammad points out the injustices that our people are suffering, they make that sin worse by accusing him of teaching hate, or by accusing him of black supremacy, or by accusing him of advocating violence, simply because he is pointing out the real factors in the problem.
We have a little time left. You don't have to hurry so much, Malcolm. You were born in Omaha, is that right?
Yes, sir.
And your family left Omaha when you were what, 1 year old?
I imagine about a year old.
And why did they leave Omaha?
Well, to my understanding, the Ku Klux Klan burned down one of their homes in Omaha.
This, a lot of this made your family feel very unhappy, I'm sure.
Well, insecure, if not unhappy.
So you must have a somewhat prejudiced point of view, a personally prejudiced point of view. In other words, you cannot look at this in a broad academic sort of way, really.
I think that's incorrect, because despite the fact that that happened in Omaha, and then when we moved to Lansing, Michigan, our home was burned down again. In fact, my father was killed by the Ku Klux Klan. And despite all of that, no one was more thoroughly integrated with whites than I. No one has lived more so in the society of whites than I. And it was only until I became a Muslim that I ceased living in the society of whites.
You say you are thoroughly integrated with the whites, Malcolm. Yes. Do you have white people in your family background?
Definitely. Most Negroes in this country have whites in their family background.
How are you going to differentiate between the white blood that's in you and the Negro blood that's in you? And you don't mind my using the term Negro, because you use this yourself.
I use it interchangeably.
I know you do. Why do you do that?
Well, I use it if it fits the purpose to use it, but I use it against my will.
You used it voluntarily in describing the incident in Los Angeles.
Still, I use it against my will.
I guess the teachings weren't thoroughly inculcated.
No, but when I say to you that the cops in Los Angeles shot down 7 unarmed Negroes, every Negro in the audience knows what I'm talking about. But when I say that they shot 7 Muslims, then a lot of the Negroes don't realize that
you're
still talking
about colored
Negroes.
People, because you say you use the term colored people. You said
I don't think I used the word colored on this program.
Yes, you did. You did when we started.
Not colored.
I think so. Black people, I'm sorry. You
black.
Did say black.
Well, we can use black, and that fits everybody.
Okay.
But, sir, the black...
Now, let me get back to another point that you made. You said that you go back home. Now, what do you mean by back home?
I've only heard the Honorable Elijah Muhammad say, back among our own people. From whence
we... You said back home. You don't mind my saying.
Right, back home. But by that, he means...
Do you mean back into the roots of Islam, or do you mean back to Africa?
Back home. And Africa. By back home, he means back into our original civilization. And if you study history, the Islamic culture existed in West Africa,
but your
Central
family
Africa.
Didn't come from an Islamic background originally, did it? I mean, you came from the proud tribes of Africa, which is
I think you'll find,
pride,
sir, that one of the background. That Islam, the Islamic culture, existed widely in Africa, Central Africa, West Africa.
I agree. I've met many people in there, Mr. O'Connor.